Goes closer to 10 wins.
Lord, gonna get me sick as a dog.
Tell me, babe, what would you like to say to me since you are marrying me?
I cannot imagine what life will be like after we're married. Because it's so amazing now.
When I was young, I thought I'd maybe marry a doctor or a lawyer. I never thought I'd marry a dry cleantologist, but here she is.
Friend Denise Gellis said to me, let's go, I'm gonna take you to the woman's event.
I came to New York for an event. I was living in Indianapolis. One of my friends said, hey, come to New York and meet some eligible lesbians.
Denise meets at the cocktail hour. She meets her friend Stephanie. And next to Stephanie is this woman.
She was really hell-bent on talking to me.
She's wearing a really tight black shirt. She was so hot and sexy.
Started talking to Marlene.
And we start to have a short conversation.
Who is this woman?
I said to her as we were leaving, here's my business card, and if you're ever back in New York.
She is really, I don't know what I was thinking.
If you'd like to have dinner, or if you're interested in any kind of sexual dallying.
She was just hitting on me, and she just said some inappropriate things.
I walk away.
And I kind of walked away from the conversation thinking.
And I think she's actually pretty stunned.
You were kind of rude and inappropriate, so goodbye.
I don't think that I was inappropriate on that particular evening.
You were totally inappropriate.
So,
are you kidding me?
I'm kind of like toning it down because what I said was even more crass than that. I just wanted to get into your pants.
3 weeks later.
About 6 weeks after.
I found her card in my back pocket.
And I was pulling out of my driveway and my phone rang.
And I was so offended by what she had said to me.
And she said, I just had to call you to tell you that
I wanted to actually tell her.
You had some chutzpah to say that most disgusting thing to me.
I was half intrigued and half horrified.
And I laughed and I said, but you called me.
But then I called her and she definitely was charming and intriguing.
She said, is this a good time? You know, I said, yeah, it's a great time.
We had the best conversation.
And my drive with Bonnie was the best first date I've ever had.
Marlene and I both have very strong personalities in very different directions.
Bonnie is more sensitive and emotional than I am.
Marlene is very solid and doesn't waver in her emotions.
She's helped me to tap into my own emotional side.
When Marlene needs to show a little more emotion, I will bring it out of her. And when I need to be a little more balanced, she balances me out.
The morning is the best time for me. It is absolutely the worst, most horrific time for Bonnie.
She puts one foot in front of the other, and I kind of need to understand why. And Marlene just keeps going and going and going.
I'm a connector. I'm that person who keeps everybody together.
Marlene has taught me how to be in a relationship, that if we have a fight, I don't pack my bags and leave.
Bonnie's sense of direction is probably the worst I've ever seen. She could not get herself out of a paper bag.
When she says she's gonna be home at 7, I expect her home at 7. But she's like, oh, I just stopped for a car wash. Oh, I have to stop by here. Oh, I gotta get my hair colored. Oh, I need a manicure. Oh, I need that. If she has 3 minutes, she puts 4 minutes into the 3 minutes.
I am definitely a neatness freak. Bonnie was completely not organized. How's the dish gonna get from the sink to the dishwasher? Someone has to do it. Not that good a cook. Not a good cook at all.
You don't say everything.
Well, that's why we have an editor.
Okay.
So he can figure out what everything actually is.
Okay.
And since you're going to assist in the edit, I can say whatever I want, and
babe,
you can chop me up and spit me out, as you normally do. And there you have it.
Let's talk about the good things.
What I admire about Bonnie is her intelligence. She's much more worldly than I am. She's compassionate, her sensitivity. She makes life exciting and challenging. She's really unique. She is the love of my life. And I'm a little emotional about this. I can't envision my life without her or our future.
I realized just how charming she is, how nurturing she is, how outgoing she is, how capable she is. Getting married means to me supporting and loving and protecting Marlene unconditionally. To accept who she is and work with it and to love her no matter what.
Getting married to me is the ultimate commitment, the being unified and one, my sharing with the rest of the world how much I love this other human being that I've chosen to have a life with. I love to take care of you. It's what I do best. At the end of the day, that's what fills me up with so much love, is actually being here for you, taking care of you, having fun with you, and you take care of me too. You take care of me probably in more ways than I take care of you. But you take care of me and my heart. I'm looking forward to the next chapter after we do get married. What that is, I don't know. I just know that I'll feel like this, our relationship is going to have another level, another depth to it that will be different. And I think until I get there, I'm not really sure, but I'm excited by what the next chapter is.
I just look forward to having more and more experiences, loving Marlene, raising Sam over the next couple of years. So I look forward to a life of health, happiness, peace, maybe some prosperity.
I've waited and look forward to this moment for a couple of years now. Gay marriage being legal in New York, we've talked about it. We have arrived at a place with all of you here with us to celebrate Bonnie and Marlene. Everybody here has been on this journey with us, so important to us. We couldn't have done this without you, and we're so happy to be able to celebrate our life, our love, our party with all of you. Thank you.
really just hope we're setting an example for my nieces, for Marlene's nieces and nephews, for her kids, for my friends' kids, that, hey, it doesn't matter what you are or who you are, as long as you love somebody else, it's okay. And that love is the most important thing. And I hope in years to come, my nieces will look at this and be like, wow, that was really cool.
Glad that you're all here to party with us and recognize the two of us and our relationship and what we've accomplished. Thanks for coming.
I can't top that. Oh man, that's it, sister. Good, boo-boo.
I can't, you're gonna get me sick.
I'm gonna get pneumonia.